portrait? Are you sure?
Yes.
They're truly wonderful.
But what?
You are simply to sit still, Dido. Not a very challenging task.
Next to Elizabeth.
As you always are, right beside each other.
I went to Scone Palace, and while I was there, I saw this painting. There, in an 18th century picture, was a black woman and a white woman. I was struck by her grace, her beauty. There was a directness in her gaze out of that painting that spoke to me. As a writer, I felt there really is a story here. You could make a story. So that was what I decided to do.
Female black director is rare in this country, especially in drama, and Amma relished the opportunity and really immersed herself in the material.
We shall be receiving visitors for dinner.
Why do you not dine with your family ever?
Because that is not correct.
May I present the second of my two nieces, Miss Dido Lindsay.
I find her repulsive.
There's a complexity to Dido. It's very difficult to paint Dido as a girl who has all of this around her, is privileged, has a family who love her, has been whisked away from this world of poverty, and have her still wanting and not have her come across as a little madam who just nothing is enough for, especially considering the lives of other people who look like her at the time.
While researching the archives at Scone, one of the things that I found most moving was her relationship with Lord Mansfield.
Papa, how may I be too high in rank to dine with the servants and too low to dine with my family?
Oh, my dear, if it were so simple.
It was very important that we got an actress who could get that balance right and could be likeable. And that's something that I felt that Gugu was able to put across fantastically.
And we can cut there. Thank you, that was absolutely perfect.
In the end, she's given the performance of what it is to be that girl at that time.
Having seen the painting at an exhibition at Kenwood House several years ago, so it's quite surreal to be actually here being Dido.
What of your mother?
I know very little of her other than the colour she has given me.
Then at least you know she was beautiful.
You can't help but love her. You can't help but feel for her.
Do you love her?
As though she were created of you and me.
It was really kind of outstanding to attract a really stellar cast, and that we could get our Tom Wilkinsons and our Penelope Wiltons and Miranda Richardsons and Emily Watsons to kind of surround her and be the great cast that we've managed to attract.
I think it's a real testament to the project. And they say, you know, as well as the script, it was just such a fascinating, fresh story that they were thrilled to be a part of it.
No idea she would be so black.
One does not make a wife of the rare and exotic.
Does she still have a tongue?
I have a tongue.
Though yours explains well enough why I may not marry your son. My greatest misfortune would be to marry into a family who would carry me as their shame.
Sometimes when we're dealing either with women in history or indeed black people in history, that we don't hear their voices. So we sometimes have to give them voices, and I feel that's what I've done.
I've enabled every rule of convention so that you would know exactly where you belong.
I don't know that I find myself anywhere.
If I had your choice, I would choose the men I love.
Seeing sort of the transition from the script to actually it becoming a living, breathing thing, you know, at first it's just a painting and then it's words on a page and then you're standing there or you're in a carriage, and I just love seeing it come alive.
Hopefully, it ticks all the right boxes, but has a great resonance underneath it all, and all inspired by this great painting.
When it comes to the matters you believe in, society is inconsequential. You break every rule when it matters enough, Papa. I am the evidence. This painting is the evidence.